गुड मॉर्निंग नाइन क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी आर डिस्कसिंग मोशन एंड सब कंटेंट्स इन दैट मोशन, एज वी आर गोइंग ऑन डिस्कसिंग टुडे रेस्ट एंड मोशन, स्केलर्स एंड वेक्टर्स, कांस्टेंट एक्सीलरेशन, डेफिनेशन ऑफ सम क्वांटिटीज, डिस्टेंस, डिस्प्लेसमेंट, स्पीड, वेलोसिटी, चेंज ऑफ वेलोसिटी एंड एक्सेलरेशन, यूनिफॉर्म एक्सेलरेशन, लाइक दैट वी कैन गो ऑन डिस्कसिंग ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. सो इफ यू गो फॉर मोशन, द बेस्ट एग्जांपल ए फ्रीली फॉलिंग बॉडी फ्रॉम सर्टेन हाइट under the influence of gravity, the object will be reached to the earth by the force of the earth, which we are calling as gravitational force, which are also called as free fall. That means from a tree. Apple which falls downwards on the earth, and there which is called as free fall. Free from a tree, an apple or anything which falls downwards onto the earth due to the free fall, which is a force of pull on the object, mother, which we are calling as gravitational force. For this force we are calling as gravitational force, G we are calling. G is nothing but acceleration due to gravity. G is equal to Gm by R square. That means Gm, universal gravitational constant. G is equal to universal gravitational constant, which is equal to 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 newton meter square by kg inverse or kg square. And next one is the mass of the earth. Which is 6 into 10 power 24 kg. M is equal to mass of the earth. And R is the radius of the earth. Which is 6.4 into 10 power 6 meter per meter. So yeah, by calculating all these things, we will get G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. 9.8 meters per second square. So here, all the bodies, irrespective of the masses, fall down with constant acceleration. Okay, all the bodies, irrespective of masses. If the mass is more or less, that's not bothered, but irrespective of the masses, every object falls freely with a constant acceleration by the pull of the earth towards it. So here the concept is motion. We know already that motion is caused by the force. That's basically we know already. If you create a motion on the resting body, we should apply force. So motion can be caused by a force. So here, what we discuss here, the force only main reason for the force. And one more thing, rest and motion are relative.
and a person, both are related. Relatively only we are calling rest and motion. Rest and motion. As we go for definition, as I already said, if a body continues its state of rest with respect to its surroundings, by going on time also, means with respect to time, the body continues its state of rest with respect to surrounding. It does not move, then it's said to be in rest. For example, a building, a bridge, heavy bridges, and a tree is in the rest. So, motion, if your body continues its change of position from time to time by its surroundings, which is called motion. So, here, motion and rest are relatives. For example, if two persons A and B are approaching near the house. Two persons are approaching near the house. With respect to the A and with respect to the B, the house is, for example, the A and B here on the road. They are walking from the road. For example, A and B. A and B on the road, they are approaching near to the house and tree. So, with respect to the what is the direction, in which direction the house is? As well as, with respect to the B, in which direction the house is? One more time, the two people are approaching near to the house. With respect to the A, in which direction? Which direction the house? With respect to the B, in which direction the house? So, with respect to A, the the house is in the right side, going on like this. With respect to the B, the house is in, with respect to the A, it is in the, left side. With respect to the B, where is approaching to the house? It's in the right side. So finally, what is correct answer? So if you ask them both of them, he will answer the house is in left side, he will answer the house is in right side. So what is the which is correct answer? Yes, by comparing the stationary object, which is house, their both answers are correct. Both the answers are correct. So here, right and left, relatively, they are relative. Right and left, up and down, and rest and motion are relative each other. So here, the conversion of a person with respect to the car and trees, we can see in our textbook with the relation of motion and rest also we can see in this concept. So here, motion is relative as we discussed already. So here, two people on the road, at a distance from the tree, and the car is moving on the same road in the opposite direction. So here, what the conversion will be takes place, you can see. the road. And a tree is there, side of the tree. It's a tree. A car is moving. Car is in this direction. The people are Srinu and Somali. Srinu and Somali. Srinu and Somali. So see the conversation between them. So the car is moving in this direction and the tree is there here. They are standing here and talking, the conversion of them. So Srinu asking to Somu, what is asking? What is the state of motion of a tree? What is the state of motion of a tree? Tree, he is asking, what is the state of motion of, state of the position of a motion of a tree? So what is the state of motion of tree? Yes, it is in rest. It is in resting position. So again he is asking, what is the state of motion of the car? State of motion of the car. Yes, the car is moving due east. Due east. Due east. So here the car is in motion. So what is the state of motion of the driver and the passengers in the car also asked. What is the motion, state of motion, of the driver and the passengers in the car? So what is the answer for this? What the answer is, they are also moving like the car. They are also moving in the, like a car. Here up to now three questions asked by what a Srinu. First question is what? What is the state of motion of the tree? Second question, what is the state of motion of the car? Third question, what is the state of motion, of the driver and passengers? Three questions asked. So here the first question answer is the tree is in the rest, and the second question answer is the car is moving in motion in the direction of due east, and the third question is that what is the state of motion of the driver comparing with the passengers? Yes, they are also in motion along with the car. Along with the car. Those are the three questions asked by the Srinu to the Somu. So how do you decide? And final question, how do you decide that what the car is, the passengers are also moving inside the car? Yes, with respect to the tree, if you consider as a stationary object, the car is in motion, that's why the passenger also and the driver also inside the car, that's why we can answer that the car is also in motion with comparing with the its surroundings of tree. So that answered by Somu to the Srinu. So with respect to the position of the car, the driver and the passenger is also moving. Isn't it? So here, as already I said, rest and motion are relative. Rest and motion are relative. What we can compare rest and motion with respect to its any one factor. Any one factor. So here, driver asks that what is the state of motion of the tree? What is the state of motion of the tree means? Tree is always in the resting position. So here, passenger also moving in the due east. What due east? Why? Because completely moving east, including with the car. That's why passengers also, they are also moving due east because of the car is in motion. So the passengers and the driver ask that passengers ask to the driver either or you are in motion or rest. Yes, the driver is also in the resting position. Why? Because he does not change his position with respect to the time, because the car only is in motion.
with respect time, but the driver and the passenger simultaneously continues their state of rest. Their state of rest. Now we'll see that the motion. What we understand the motion? Yes, motion is nothing but if any object in motion, if it changes its position continuously with the time comparing to its surroundings, is called the body is said to be in motion. And as well as rest means, if the body does not change its position with respect to the time comparing to its surroundings, which is called in rest. So here tree is in rest, tree is in resting position, comparing to the car is in motion. So motion and rest are related. So as well as distance and displacement also, as I explained already. And once again, distance is the actual path traveled by the object from initial position to the final position. Actual path means the total path traveled by the object, either an aeroplane or a car or a scooter or any object which is moving or a uniform motion. And here displacement and distance are different. Displacement is nothing but it is the shortest path from initial position to the final position of the object. For example, a ball which is thrown vertically upwards, the ball initially moves with a horizontal certain speed. After some time, the ball, if you throw a ball, the ball initially moves with some horizontal direction. After some time, it continuously try to fall by making a curve. A curvilinear motion like that, it falls like that. So it makes like this. So when it reaches the earth, here if you see A and S, B like that. So here the total distance and displacement you can understand in this concept. So what is the distance travel? It travels the total distance. It covered the actual path. This is the path the ball has been traveled. This we are considering as a distance. Distance travel. So here, and one more factor, displacement. Displacement is the, in this situation, AB is the displacement. AB is the displacement. So how can you define the displacement? Displacement is the shortest distance, means which is shortest form or shortest path which the object reached from A to B, from initial position to the final position. So as already said, distance and displacement in SI system are in case meters per meters. Meters are the units. In CGS, centimeters. As already said, so your distance is a scalar quantity, displacement is a vector quantity. So as already written on the board, scalars and vectors. Here distance is a scalar. Here there is no need of mentioning the direction. As the definition, if you want, scalar, the physical quantity which has only magnitude, there is no need of representation of the scalar with the direction. Then these are called scalars. So distance is a scalar. When you mention the distance, there is no need of mentioning the direction. Only magnitude you can define. So when the vector, for example, here displacement is a vector. A vector can be represented by an arrow mark. The arrow indicates that the two parts of the wing, head and tail, the arrow direction indicates the direction of motion of the object. So here finally what I am saying, displacement is a vector quantity as it consists of both magnitude and direction. As our distance is not having direction, only magnitude arrow. So here the vector can be represented by arrow mark, as I already said. So the arrow will be represented as a vector A, B,
So it is a tail and its head, and the total distance, its magnitude. It's a magnitude. Magnitude means the quantity. That means 5 meters or 10 meters alike. So the quantity of the vector, which is having its length, that is nothing but considering as a magnitude. Magnitude and its direction. AB indicates the arrow or its direction. In this direction. So here the displacement and the distance are depth. So here another thing that we are having here, constant acceleration. As already said, a freely falling body travels to the earth with a constant acceleration by the pull of the earth. And next one, definition of distance and displacement. We will see now. I will write on the board, you can copy the distance. So distance is nothing but what a length of the path is called distance. Length of the path, distance. Length of the path. Length of the path. And SI unit is, in this first point, SI unit is meter. And CGS unit is centimeter. CGS unit is centimeter. That length of the path is called a distance. SI unit is meter centimeter. And third point is it is a scalar one. It is a scalar. It is a scalar quantity. Next one is displacement. Displacement. Displacement is the which is a length, magnitude of length between magnitude of length between initial position to magnitude of length. Magnitude of length between the initial and the final position. Between initial and final position. Initial and final position. So it is a vector quantity. Second one is, it is a vector. Third one is units. If you see, SI unit is meter. SI unit is meter. SI unit is meter. Next one is, so try to copy this on the board. What are the definitions and units? Next one we see the speed. Speed is nothing but the rate at which the particle covers a distance along the given path. Along the given path. The rate at which the particle covers a distance along the given path. Along the given path, which is called speed. At what rate it covers the distance. So speed is equal to distance by time. The rate at which it covers the path is called speed. Next one is speed. The rate at which a particle covers a distance in a given path get given a. This is the definition. And speed is equal to distance by time. Speed is equal to distance by time. Speed is equal to distance by time. So SI unit meter per second. SI unit is meter by second. And CGS unit is centimeter per second. Centimeter per second. And it's a scalar quantity. Speed is a scalar quantity. Speed is a scalar quantity. The other units of speed also we can measure. It was other units also in kmph also. Kmph, kilometer per hour. Kilometer per hour. Kilometer per hour also you can apply to measure the speed. Isn't it? So copy the definitions. Next one, velocity. Velocity, the rate of change of displacement. Velocity, the rate of change of displacement. The rate of change of displacement is called velocity. First point, velocity is equal displacement by time. Displacement by time. Displacement by time. Basic units are again meter per second, units, then case meter per second, CGS, centimeter per second. And next one is a vector quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. Vector quantity. And the other definitions we will discuss in the next class, like change of velocity, acceleration, average acceleration, instantaneous acceleration, and uniform acceleration, non-uniform acceleration, deceleration, as well as equations of motion, which are related in this chapter, we will discuss in the coming classes. Thank you very much.